A large group of people that are solely devoted to
the similar ideas and the greater good of their culture.
Otto von Bismarck was the Prime Minister of Prussia. He had a real politic ruling style, which was politics without any room for idealism. He made an alliance with Austria, and they took over Denmark's provinces, Schleswig and Holstein. Russia gained respect from Germany and became the leader of the unified German states. Austria declared war on Prussia in 1866, called the Seven Weeks War. Austria lost Venetia, given to Italy. Prussia won the war and took control of northern Germany. This was called the North German Confederation.
Southern Germans were Catholic and Prussians were Protestant. That was one main reason why they did not want Prussians to control them.
Bismarck made up a story that the French ambassador insulted the Prussian king. This caused many problems. France declared war on Prussia in 1870, called the Franco-Prussian War.
Prussians surrounded French troops and Napoleon III until they surrendered.
Southern Germans then accepted Prussian leadership.
They captured Versailles, and King Wilhelm I of Prussia was crowned Kaiser. Prussia then took over Germany and Europe.
Lasciatemi cantare con la chitarra in mano.
Camillo di Cavour was Sardinia's prime minister. He wanted to gain lands from northern Italy for Sardinia. Giuseppe Garibaldi was a confident nationalist soldier that led other Italian nationalists. He agreed to unite the areas he had conquered in southern Italy with Sardinia's lands. He willingly stepped aside to let King Victor Emmanuel II rule. Venetia was added to Italy in 1866. This cartoon shows the King of Sardinia receiving lands taken by Garibaldi. This was one of the last steps towards the unification of Italy. In 1870, Napoleon III took his troops out of Rome. The Italian troops moved in without a fight, and Rome was now controlled by Italy. Although Rome was under Italian control, the Pope still controlled Vatican City.
German unification is nationalism because all of the Germanic states came together under Prussian rule. Their culture and similar beliefs were unified into one nation state.
In most places, people follow the saying, monkey see, monkey do. This is true because when people see that someone or something has done something like unification, they think that they can do it too. It is inspirational to see that someone has gotten what they want through nationalism or supporting a cause.
This fulfills our definition of nationalism because the events in Italy involved many people in the area. A lot of people have to come together for it to truly be considered nationalism. Also, they rebelled for the greater good of their culture. The smallest Italian states had similar culture, and this created a sense of unity. If they had not pushed Austria out, they would have been oppressed even more. This has affected modern-day Europe, because if countries like Austria had taken over, then their empire may have flourished more, because the Mediterranean Sea is a key point for trade and other areas.